Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Mark Learmonth from Caledonia Mining. Mark, great to have you on the line. How are you doing?
I'm doing very well. Thanks for having me.
Good. Now, I saw in your results release that you consider your 2022 to have been outstanding. What's so good about it?
It has been good, really. So the first, we published our Q2 numbers late last week. So, you know, production for the year so far, we're just slightly under 60,000 ounces, you know, which is significantly higher than last year. And for the last two quarters, we've exceeded a quarterly production rate of 20,000 ounces a quarter, which clearly, given the fact that our target production rate is 80,000 ounces, you can see now for the last two quarters, we've been slightly ahead of that run rate. So that's good news. And that translates into strong profit. So gross profit for the 3 months was 15 million. Gross profit for the 9 months was 50 million. The net profit for the quarter was 8. And again, 25 million for the year. So yeah, it's all going very well. Cash flows remain very strong. So in terms of operations, things are going very nicely. But I think in addition to that, we're also demonstrably now made some significant progress on our broader strategy, which is basically to build from Blanket Mine and create a multi-asset Zimbabwe-focused gold producer, which is substantially bigger than where we are today. So we've had some good news flow on that in the last 2 weeks as well, which you know, perhaps we can move on and talk about.
Sure thing, yeah. Get us up to speed with those developments, please.
Okay, well, we announced on the a week ago, last Monday, that we'd upgraded the resource base at Marley Green. As people may recall, that in November last year, we bought an asset called Marley Green, which is in the Midlands, for $4 million. And that has a 1 million ounce inferred resource base. Last week, we announced that we've managed to upgrade that resource base. So about 440,000 ounces are now moved from inferred to M&I. Much greater level of certainty, and we can now do further exploration there with a view to, you know, building up the resource base further and eventually doing a feasibility study. Then on the 2nd of November, we announced the acquisition of a further exploration project called Matapa. Matapa is very, very exciting because it's immediately adjacent to the Bilbo's property. In July, we announced that we'd agreed a transaction to acquire Bilbo's. Bilbo's already has about 2.5 million ounces at a good grade. Matapa is immediately adjacent to that. There's no formal resource on that at this stage, but we believe it is potentially much bigger and much higher grade than Bilbo's. So the two of those together could potentially create a world-class gold mine. And then this morning, we announced that we've now technically connected the new solar plant to Blanket Mine. And so power is now beginning to flow from the solar plant to Blanket Mine. Over the course of the next sort of couple of weeks, that will be ramped up to full production. But that should provide about just over a quarter of Blanket's average daily power requirements, displacing grid power, which is somewhat more expensive, but also displacing diesel power, which is fabulously more expensive. So the saving there will be about $3 million a year. So that will add about, it'll save us about $37, $38 an ounce, which is about 5% of our online costs, but also just reduce our environmental footprint and just make our power supply more stable. And that has been an impediment to production over the course of the last few years. So all in all of these things just happen to be coming together at sort of the same time, which is good news. It's nice to see our share price react accordingly.
Well, it all sounds extremely positive. It leaves me wondering what it is that could possibly slow you down at this point. So are there any particular challenges that you're
My sister-in-law says, what could possibly go wrong? Clearly you've got the ordinary mining risks, you know. We may find that we struggle to, but at this stage there's nothing that we're aware of. You know, there's the usual mining risks, there's the usual the fact that we don't control the gold price clearly. But at this stage, there's nothing that we're aware of. Clearly, we would have announced it if we were aware of anything. There's nothing really unusual that we can see that's causing us great concern. So hopefully, touch wood, we can keep the ship steady and continue to make progress towards this strategic objective of becoming a multi-asset Zimbabwe-focused gold producer.
Well, as always, let me wish you the very best of luck, Mark, and thank you very much for joining us this morning on Proactive.
Thank you. Thank you very much.